Now, I want to talk a little bit about opt-outs and the bowl system. And I'll start with this. As bad as the CFP semis were, every star player on all four teams played in them. Why? Because they still had a road to play for the national championship. Now, let's not get it twisted. No other games mattered. Period. I don't care what you think about the granddaddy of them all. I don't care what you think about the Sugar Bowl. I don't care what you think about the Music City Bowl, which was awesome. I don't think you would care what you think about the Peach Bowl, which was awesome. They didn't matter because the college football playoff system and the sheer number of bowls makes them all but irrelevant to a player who is more interested in protecting the most valuable commodity he has, his body, so that he is in the best shape possible, medically, if not physically, to perform for the NFL draft, all right? We saw in the Sugar Bowl, perhaps the best quarterback available in the 2022 draft, Matt Corral, go down with an apparent ankle injury. Turned out it looked worse than it was, and he's going to be okay, but what if it wasn't? Jalen Smith had this at Notre Dame. His knee exploded. He fell on the draft before it, because of it, and then later, my Dallas Cowboys cut him, right? That's just what it is. A lot of that has to do with him getting hurt in one game that doesn't matter. So Matt Corral wanted to play in the Sugar Bowl. Let's not get that twisted. He never thought about opting out, and that's to his credit because he wanted to do what he wanted to do. And perhaps if he plays, it's not 21-7 Baylor, and they don't lose. But even if he does, what does he gain from that? Not a whole hell of a lot, except intrinsically he feels great about it. Ole Miss fans feel great about it, and they gave him a loud applause when he walked back out there on crutches, but he was still on crutches, which is kind of my point here, all right? So when we look at the Matt Corrals of the world, we have to also look at the Kenny Picketts of the world, the Kenneth Walker III of the world, the Kyron Williams of the world, the Kyle Hamiltons of the world. I can keep going, right? There's a number of players who are stars at their respective schools who chose not to play in these bowl games in preparation for the NFL draft. So we've had a bunch of people say, look, this generation of player doesn't care about bowl games. They don't care about anything but playing for the national championship and getting to the NFL. You said that like it's a bad thing. You said that like it's not the commonality. You said that like it is not the world they live in. Because in the 90s, when a lot of the old heads were still playing football, number one, we didn't play as many games. We started playing 12 games in 2006. This is why you're seeing a lot of teams that have 12-win seasons for the first time in their school histories, because it used to be you had to be undefeated and win a national championship to go 12-0. It's not so anymore. Now you go 15-0, okay? The other aspect of this is there are more bowl games than there have ever been. There are 41 bowl games, and I'm not the person to say that there are too many bowl games. I am going to say it's not going to mean a whole hell of a lot to a player that he gets to play in the bowl game if he knows that Rutgers gets in with a 5-7 record on an APR score, all right? It just doesn't mean that much. Bowl gifts aren't going to do it anymore because there are more bowls. It's not a prize. That's not what you play the game for. You play the game for an opportunity to win championships and to play in the NFL. If you can still guarantee those things, Alabama, Georgia, you're probably going to be okay. But let's not get it twisted. The reason that players are at Georgia and Alabama is so they can get to the NFL. It's not to win championships. It's never really been about winning championships for about 25 years, okay? Thanks for watching this video. And remember, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any other videos on the number one ranked show YouTube channel.